For problem 211, classify each of the structure as statically determinate or indeterminate. If indeterminate, specify the degree of indeterminacy. For this problem, we can draw free body diagram for the beam. I don't care about the vertical member, which is support. So we have only one reaction here. This one looks like cooler. We have only one reaction perpendicular to it. And we have here two reaction. That means your R equal three. Number of parts, only one part. We don't have any intermediate bin. So the relation between R and the 3N, they are equal. So your structure is stable. We don't have any special case. And R equal 3N determinate. For the second part, how many reaction we have here? We have two reaction, one reaction, two reaction. So R equal to 5. How many parts? Only one part. We don't have any intermediate bin. So R and 3N. R is greater than 3N. That means we have many unknowns but limited number of equilibrium equation. So this structure is stable but indeterminate. Indeterminate means I can not solve it with the equilibrium equation. So how many indeterminacy? R is 5. 3N is 3, so R is greater than 3N with 2, that means second degree, stable indeterminate for the second degree. Indeterminacy. The third problem, we can divide it into two parts. The first part, we have one reaction, two reaction. We have here the same two reaction, but in opposite direction. This support is fixed, so we have three reaction. Remember, this reaction counted as two, one reaction and three. So your R number of reaction equal six, N number of part is two. The relation between R and the three N are equal. Your structure is stable and determinate. Stable, we don't have any special case or reaction not parallel to each other. All of the reaction not intersects at the same point, no special case, so it's stable. Determinate, because number of unknowns equal to number of available equilibrium equation. For this problem, we can divide it into three parts. How many reactions do you have? We have here three. We have one at this roller. We have two here, the same two, but in opposite direction. We have one and can be in the same value here, but in opposite direction. Only one reaction at this point because this one not bend, it's roller. This support is fixed, so we have three reaction. So how many unknown do you have? Three here, this one counted as one, two, one, three. So R equal to 4, 6, 7, 10. How many parts do you have? Three. So the relation between R and the 3N, 3N is greater than, R is greater than 3N. Your structure looks good, is stable. We don't have any special case with this structure. We don't have any issue, but it's indeterminate. We cannot solve it because number of unknowns reaction is greater than number of availability of equation. How many times? First time, indeterminate. Okay, for the last one, we can divide it into two parts. We have here two reaction, one reaction, two reaction, same value, but in opposite direction, we have here two reaction. These reactions counted as two, one, two, two. So are equal to 4, 5, 7. N number of parts is 2. So the relation between R and 3N, R is greater than 3N. Your structure looks good, no problem, so it's stable, but I cannot solve it indeterminate. How many times? One time indeterminate. First order or first time. For problem 215, classify each of the structure as statically determinate, statically indeterminate, stable, or unstable. For the first one, for this problem, we have only two reactions. This one and this one. Remember, this type of support is roller. That means we have only one reaction, which is perpendicular to the base of the roller. The only two reactions in this problem are intersects at this point, so that all reactions are connected at one point. That means your structure is unstable. Not good. Unstable means there is collapse will happen. The second one for this problem, remember, we have equation called R and 3N. We need to determine what is the relation between R, which is number of reaction, 3N, N is number of parts. We have here only one part, N equal to 1. This one is one part. We don't have any pin inside the structure. So N equal to 1. R, number of reaction. Here we have two reactions. It's pin. We have here one reaction. It's roller. That means R equal to 3. So R and 3N are equal. So your structure is stable and determinate. Determinate means I can solve it. Number of equation equal to number of unknown. The third problem, same thing. We have only one part. There is no intermediate pin. So N is one part. Number of reaction, we have roller, we have roller, we have roller. That means your number of reaction are 3. So R and 3N are equal. So your structure is stable and determinate. For problem 217, classify each of the structure as statically determinate, statically indeterminate, or unstable. For this one, we can divide it to three parts. Looks like this. How many reactions do you have? We have here one reaction, two reaction, same value but in opposite direction. We have one reaction at this roller. We have two reaction here, same value but in opposite direction. This support is fixed support, so we have three reaction. Remember, at this pin, it counted as two unknowns, two reaction, because both of them are the same value but in opposite direction. Here counted as two unknown. We have here three reaction, here one reaction, and here is one reaction. That means R, the total number of reaction, 3, 5, 6, 8, 9. How many bars do you have in this problem? We have three bars. Remember, we cannot divide only at the intermediate pin. So what is the relation between R and 3N? They are equal. That means your structure is stable and determinate. Determinate means I can solve it. For the second part of the problem, we have this frame. We can divide it into three parts. Looks like this. I have here two reaction, same value but in opposite direction, two reaction, same value but in opposite direction, two reaction, same value, but in opposite direction, and two reaction. Remember, these four reaction are only two, counted as two, same value, but in opposite direction, counted as two, counted as two. We have two more here, and two more here. So how many reaction do you have? In this problem, we have two, or we have two, six, eight, nine, sorry, I'm sorry, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. N number of parts, 1, 2, 3, 4. So what is the relation between R and 3N? They are equal. Although the relation between R and 3N are equal, but this frame is unstable. This frame is a special case. This member considered as two force member. That means we can remove it and put only one reaction in a special case. One reaction. That means all the reaction in the frame are parallel. That means your structure is unstable, because if you have horizontal force, that frame will move horizontally. So this one is unstable. Third problem, it's only R and N. Number of reaction, we have one here, two here. That means R is three. N, only one part, we don't have any intermediate bin, so N is 1. So the relation between R and 3N, they are equal. No special case in the structure. Special case means all reactions are intersect at one point, all reactions are parallel to each other. No special case. That means your structure is stable and determinate. I can solve it. The last one. In this equation, we can divide it into two parts. How many reactions do you have? I have here one reaction. We have here two, same value but in opposite direction. We have here two reactions. Remember, this reaction counted as two. One more, two more. That means R equal to 2, 4, 5. N number of parts is 2, so R is 5, 3N is 6. That means N, R is smaller than 3N, that means your structure is unstable. We have many equilibrium equation, but we have less number of unknowns. That means your structure is unstable. For problem 229, determine the reactions at supports A, B, C, and E for this compound B. So first step, we need to divide it into three parts. First part, A, E. Second part, E, F. Third part will be F, D. For the first part, we have point B. Third part, we have point C. What do you have in reactions? At A, we have two reaction, YA, XA. B is a roller, we have YB. E is bin, so we have two reaction, one horizontal and one vertical, XE and YE, same value but in opposite direction on the other point, YE, XE. F is a bin, we have two reaction, XF, YF, same value but in opposite direction. At C, we have one vertical reaction, D is a roller, one vertical reaction. We have distributed load here, uniform distributed load, two kip per foot, another one on the third part, 3 kip per foot. The equivalent force for the distributed load at the middle span, the value will be the area 2 times 12 equal 24 kip. The equivalent force here 3 times total distance 12 equal 36 kip. Remember, we have three equilibrium equations, summation f of x equals 0, summation f of y equals 0, summation moment at any point equals 0. We need to apply these three equilibrium equations on each part of the problem. Third part for the third part, I will start with the third part because I have only one horizontal reaction. Summation f of x equals 0. That means the only horizontal force is xf equals 0. That means xf here is 0. That means xf here is 0. For the second part, summation f of x equals 0, xe minus xf equals 0. xf was 0. That means xe equals 0. So xe here is 0. For the first part, summation f of x equals 0, xa minus xe equals 0, that means xa equals 0. For the second part, if I apply summation moment at e equals 0, assume clockwise is positive direction. Yeah, we forgot something here. We have concentrated load, 16 kip here. We have concentrated load, 8 kip on the second part. So, summation moment at E, that means we have 8 time distance equal to 9. Negative YF time distance equal to 12 equal 0. The only unknown here is YF. The value of YF equal 6 kip. So YF here is 6. That means YF here is 6. Summation F of Y. Equal 0, we have YE negative 8 positive YF equal 0. The value of YF was 6. That means the only unknown here is YE equal 2 kip. YE is 2 kip, same value here but in opposite direction. I will go to the third part, apply the remaining equilibrium equation. Summation moment at D equal 0, assume counterclockwise is my positive direction. You can assume what you want. 36 excuse me, 36 time half distance, which is 6, negative YC time 12 positive YF time total distance, which is 24 equals 0. The value for YF was 6. That means the only unknown here is YC equal to 30 kip. YC is 30. Summation F of Y equals 0. We have negative YF, positive YC, positive YD, negative 36, which is the equivalent distributed load, equal 0. So YF was 6, YC was 30. That means the only unknown is YD equal 12 kip. Go back to First part. Summation moment at A equals 0. Assume clockwise is my positive. So 24 times 6 negative YB times 12 positive 16 times 20 positive YE times 24. Total distance equal 0. Remember the value of YE was 2. The only unknown here is YB equal 16 kip. Then summation F of Y equal 0. We have YA positive, negative 24, positive YB, negative 16, negative YE equal 0. YB was 16, YE was 2. The only unknown here is YA equal to 10 kip. So, the required in this problem to calculate the reaction at A, 0 horizontal, 10 vertical at B, 16 vertical, at C, 30 vertical, and D vertical. What's the value of D? 12. That's it. For problem 242, determine the horizontal and vertical components of reaction A at A, C, and D. For this compound frame, we are going to divide it into two parts. The first part is the vertical member D, C. The second part is part A, C. Reaction at A, it's two reaction because we have it's been XA, YA. At C, it's been, that means we have two reaction, XC, YC. You can assume any direction as you like. Same value, but in opposite direction, YC, XC, D, it's been, that means we have two reaction, YD and XD. Based on your reaction, you are going to get a value with a sign. If your sign is positive, your assumption is correct. If your sign is negative, your assumption isn't correct. You have to assume to the opposite direction. We have here horizontal distributed load, uniform distributed load with value of 15 kilonewton per meter. We have two concentrated load here. One is 50 kilonewton, the other one is 40 kilonewton. Remember, we have three equilibrium equations: summation F of X equals 0, summation F of Y equals 0, summation moment at any point equals 0. We are going to apply this equilibrium equation on the two parts. I am going to start with the second part, CD. Summation moment at D equals 0, and I will assume the anticlockwise is a positive direction. But before doing this, the equivalent force of the distributed load will be horizontal to left. The value will be 15 times distance 6 equal 90 kilonewton. So if you apply summation moment at D equals 0, we have 90 times distance 3 negative XC times distance 6. Remember, XD, YD are cancelled at the same point. YC does not have lever arm, so it will be cancelled also. So the only unknown in this equation is XC. The value of XC is 45 kilonewton. So XC here is 45. Same value here, but in opposite direction, 45. Summation F of X equals 0. We have XD in positive direction, negative 90, positive XC equals 0. The value of XC was 45. That means The only unknown here is xd equal 45 kilonewton. So xd is 45. For part, the first part AC, we can apply summation f of x equals 0. Remember, I will go back to second part to determine vertical reaction yd and yc. But first, let's do it with first part AC. Summation f of x equals 0, we have xa negative xc equals 0. Value of xc was 45. That means xa equal 45 kilonewton. So the value here is 45 kilonewton. Submission moment at A equals 0. I'm going to assume this direction, which is clockwise, is positive. So we have 50 time distance 1.5 plus 40 time 3.5. Negative YC time distance, the total distance is 5. Negative XC time vertical distance, which is 4, equal 0. One more thing. Remember, if you are talking moment at any point, the force and the distance must be perpendicular. That means if your force is horizontal, your distance is vertical. If your force is vertical, your distance must be horizontal. Value of xc was 45. That means the only unknown here is yc. Value of yc equal 7 kilonewton. So yc is 7. Same value here, but in opposite direction, 7. If you apply summation f of y equals 0, we have ya negative 50, negative 40, and we have positive yc equals 0. Value of yc was 7. That means the only unknown is ya equal 83 kilonewton. We can go back to the second part and apply summation f of y equals 0. We have yd vertical in the opposite, in the positive direction. We have only yc in the negative direction equals 0. Yc was 7. That means yd is the only unknown equal to 7 kilonewton. So yd is 7 kilonewton. One more thing. If your value of your reaction is positive, that means your assumption is correct. If your value is negative, that means your assumption isn't correct, but it should be your value is correct, but in the opposite direction. So reaction at A, reaction at C, reaction at D were determined.